Old school paper and post. Still popular. In fact, the bulk of electoral registration is still being done this way. But a couple of weeks ago, Parliament introduced a new way of doing things. And it's catching on.
For such a new system to have been launched, we've had quite a good response from the public at large. We've had over 600 persons have registered and are going through the process, and I think at least 500 odd have completed the full process. There's about 100 people who are pending, who are going through the process themselves. And we've had in the region of 200 persons who have actually made use of this facility to register for the Register of Electors online. So I think, you know, given that it's only two weeks that we started, I think the response is quite good.
The system is simple enough to use. It does take a bit of time, and you'll be having to use a number of different platforms, including an iPhone or Android app for verification. But the advantages are clear. You can do this from home or the office, and Parliament can communicate with you directly by email or text message.
For a start, it's a more personal way of communications, as users who have already started using this system will have noticed. We communicate with them directly via SMS, a text message saying, yes, you've been accepted, no, you've not been accepted, your photograph is not very good, please send me another photograph. So it's a very good way of interchanging information between Parliament and the user. As you know, we've now got new legislation in place. The government has now moved from a closed register of electors to an open register of electors. So as from the 1st of June, when we publish this register, we change, and it's up to the person themselves to be able to change their particulars. So we're giving them the facility, either you come down to Parliament and you have to take time off work to come down to Parliament to update your particulars, or you register online and then you can send your particulars online to us and we do the process electronically.
Parliament is now looking at taking the next step. A big chunk of the electorate is overseas, students, for example, and sponsored patients. In the coming weeks or months, the staff will be looking into making registration for postal voting available on the platform.